second part of the video, demonstration of high performance liquid chromatography, HPLC. For practical demonstration, we will learn assay of paracetamol tablets by using RP-HPLC method. Instrument facility at Dr. D.Y. Patil Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences and Research, Pimpri, Pune have quaternary gradient HPLC system of make Shimadzu. The system is equipped with LC software. HPLC analysis have various steps. First, mobile phase pre-treatment and preparation, standard and sample solution preparation, purging and washing, sample and standard analysis, and finally the detection. So we'll go one by one. So first is mobile phase preparation. Optimized mobile phase for paracetamol assay is 40% volume by volume of methanol and 60% volume by volume of double distilled water with 0.1% glacial acetic acid. So we'll transfer the methanol and water. Mobile phase pre-treatment is carried out before HPLC analysis and is performed by sonication and vacuum filtration. So we will now sonicate our solvents. This is an ultrasonic water bath with make as Vansar and capacity of 1.4 liters. Switch on the instrument. We will set the temperature at ambient temperature and the timer for 5 minutes. To sonicate our solution, to remove all the entrapped. Preferred sonication time is for from 3 to 5 minutes. We'll now move to the second step of vacuum filtration, for which we'll use vacuum filtration assembly. So here you can see the vacuum filtration assembly. We have a funnel where we can load our solvent and a reservoir where the filtered solvent is collected. In between these two, we have a connector where we will place our membrane filter. For filtration of solvent, we'll use 0.45 micron filters, and for filtration of sample, we'll use 0.2 micron filters. Now we'll place the membrane filter in between in the connector. And we'll filter our sonicated solvent. After sonication and vacuum filtration, our mobile phase is ready for analysis. Now we'll move with standard and sample solution preparation. Standard here is paracetamol pure drug powder. Weigh 10 mg of paracetamol powder and dissolve in suitable solvent. Here we have used mobile phase to dissolve the solvent to prepare a solution of 100 microgram per ml. This 100 microgram per ml standard solution is diluted to have working standard in the range of 5 to 50 microgram per ml. Working standards of 5 to 50 microgram per ml are prepared to form calibration curve of paracetamol. Now we'll prepare our sample solution. For assay of paracetamol, we'll use a paracetamol tablet with label claim 500 mg. We will weigh 20 tablets and calculate the average weight of the tablet. We'll then crush the tablet into fine powder and we'll take a powder equivalent quantity to 100 mg of paracetamol and transfer into a 100 ml volumetric flask. We'll add sufficient mobile phase and sonicate the solution to dissolve maximum paracetamol in the solution. We'll then make the solution to 100 ml and filter to obtain a solution of 1000 microgram per ml. We'll see the calculations for the sample preparation. Here you can see the calculations for sample preparation. So the label claim is each uncoated tablet contains paracetamol IP 500. We have weighed 20 tablets and this is the average weight of the tablet. We have calculated the weight equivalent to 100 mg of paracetamol, which is 121 mg. So now we'll move to the HPLC instrument. We'll switch on the instrument and the PC. Software with this Shimazo system is LC Solution. Double click the LC Solution icon on the PC. A window will open with LC Solution Launcher menu where various options in operation menu are real-time analysis, offline editing during the online operation, and post-run analysis. For a new analysis, I'll click on Analysis 1. It will ask for user ID and password and then OK. The instrument will now connect with the software. This is real-time analysis window where we have data acquisition where the real-time analysis can be viewed. We have assistant bar where the commands can be given. Then we have instrument parameter view where the details of method analysis can be input. And the instrument monitor where the temporary change in mobile flow rate and the concentration of solvent can be given. To start with, we'll switch on the pump. We can give command to the instrument either directly through the display on the system or through the software. We'll operate our system through software. Here we can see the pump is on. As it's a quaternary gradient system, here we can see four suction filters labeled as A, B, C and D. Before we start with analysis, we need to purge the channels to remove the air bubbles through the tubings. For purging, the filters are dipped in distilled water and the purge valve is rotated anti-clockwise to open it. Now we'll give the command on the instrument monitor as 100% to purge filter C. We'll initiate the purge by clicking on this purge tab. Purging is carried out for 3 minutes at the flow rate of 8 ml per minute.
same way we can purge all the channels. Now we'll off the purge valve by rotating clockwise and we'll on the pump. Next step of analysis is washing, where again double distilled water is used. For washing is done for 30 minutes or based upon the previous analysis. To minimize the analysis time of HPLC, the pump are kept for washing and simultaneously preparation of mobile phase, standard and sample is done. Now we'll create a new method file. For giving inputs for new method file, we'll use instrument parameter view, where we have two tabs, normal and advanced. In normal, we'll select the pump mode as low pressure gradient. We'll give the pump flow rate as 1 ml per minute and we'll give the concentration of B solvent as 60%. Automatically, it will take 40% for solvent A. We'll then switch to advanced settings, where in data acquisition will give the total run time of the analysis, the start time as 0 minutes and the end time as 10 minutes or based upon the analysis. Then in pump we have already given the inputs for flow rate and the concentration of solvents. We'll just give the input for pressure limit as maximum till 350 bar. Then we'll give the inputs for PDA detector, where we'll select D2 lamp for analysis. And finally, controller, where we'll take event 1 and event 2 as we are using two channels. After this settings in normal and advanced, we'll download our method file. The system will ask for a command to save the file, where it will ask for the path. We'll give the path for saving our file. We'll save the method file as para standard. Here the settings are saved and we can see here as para standard. With this settings, now we'll start with the baseline correction or column equilibration. We have already put our mobile phase and we'll just click on plot. So here we can see the baseline plotting has been started. Here we can view our straight line. Straight line indicates the column equilibration. Now the system is ready for our standard and sample injection. So we'll start with this single start. If we click on this single start on the assistant bar, a window will pop up as single run, where we need to give the inputs for file name. And inputs for data file. We need to give the path where we need to save our data file. Once we give the input for sample name and data file, it will automatically take method file path and then we'll click OK. Once we click OK, the system will ask for sample injection. We'll use hypodermic syringe for sample injection. We'll fill the syringe with paracetamol working standard as 10 microgram per ml. Care should be taken to remove the air bubble through the syringe. And now we'll insert our syringe in sample injector. Once the sample is injected, we'll turn the knob from load to inject position. And the analysis will start. Here we can see the single start analysis has been initiated. This is the chromatogram obtained for the sample injection. Similar way we can do for all other standards and sample. Once the injections are done, we can analyze our data in post-run analysis. For post-run analysis, we'll again click on LC solution software. Now we'll go in post-run operation menu. This is the post-run analysis window where we can have a chromatogram view and the spectrum view for peak purity and peak profile. We'll open our saved data file. We'll give the path for the data file. I'll open one of the file which is previously analyzed. Here we can see the chromatogram for paracetamol standard 30 microgram per ml. Now we'll ask for display multi-chromatogram table where we'll give the input about the wavelength as 254 nanometer and then apply and click OK. To view the details of the chromatogram obtained, we'll go in view tab in peak table. Here we get the area and retention time of our sample. Here we'll also get the theoretical plate and tailing factor. The theoretical plate of any analysis should be more than 2000 and the tailing factor needs to be less than 2. We can also see the peak purity profile of our chromatogram. The peak purity index for this chromatogram is 0.99 and the peak profile we can see at different wavelengths. In this way, we can analyze all our developed chromatograms. So we have analyzed all the standards and sample. We'll note the area of all the standard paracetamol sample in the concentration range from 5 to 50 microgram and in triplicate. So these are the area of our solution, standard solution. This is the average weight of the area. We can create a calibration curve as concentration versus area where we'll get the y equals to mx plus c equation and r square value. We'll use this linearity curve for SA calculation. These are the calculation for SA of paracetamol where we have analyzed our sample in again triplicate. These are the area of our sample solution and this is the average area of the sample. We'll use the formula for determining the content of drug sample as peak area of sample into weight of standard into dilution factor of sample into average weight of the tablet divided by peak area of the standard into dilution factor of standard into weight of tablet in of powder in grams. So here I have put the values for the sample and standard which comes to 505.38 mg per tablet. To calculate the percent drug content of the drug in sample divided by label claim in 200 which gives 101.07%, this percent drug content was found to be within IP limits. So here we have completed the analysis of paracetamol. Same way we can use HPLC system for analysis of pure drug, synthetic formulation and herbal formulation. For any successful analysis, three parameters are required, that is a validated instrument, a validated method and a validated analyst. So stay tuned with us for further videos on system suitability parameters and troubleshooting. For more informative videos, you can subscribe our channel DPU Pharmacy. Thank you.